At breakfast, I was having a conversation with a woman filmmaker for from Saudi Arabia. Mm-hmm. And this is a question we are often asked in panels. And what we both agreed upon was the fact that it's a very young industry in Saudi Arabia. And for me, animation is like just 10 or 12 years old in India. It has still not got the power and the money for the differences between the gender to really work out. So we sometimes find ourselves very lost with answers, like in the sense it would be as difficult for a man right. who was making the kind of film that I was making to find the finances for the film. Right. However, in the kind of countries that we live in, for me to go from my workplace to from my home to my workplace, I could get raped, you know, on the way. India is one of the most dangerous place for women to be working in. That is the reality. Which is a gender-biased reality. The fact that I might not have the same problem as finding finance as the man who's setting out to make his own film is different. As can I even reach that place to be able to then go and find the finance for my film? So the reality is very different. And I think there is one discussion about how it is within the industry. There needs to be a discussion how it is outside the industry for developing countries.
Yes.
Which is very different from the developed countries.
What gave you the courage to do what you're doing?
My family, my my support system. I am educated. I am, in that sense, privileged. And I live in a place like Bombay, which is not too unsafe for women. Therefore, I am doing what I'm doing. And it's just a privilege and the sheer matter of luck that I've not been... I've been able to do it. However, in a place like Bombay, if you have education and if you have a certain amount of privilege, you can live like you are living in Paris or London.
Right.
And my maid or somebody who works in that place in the same city, in a lower class, might not enjoy it. Yeah. Essentially, the script writing and telling the story, I was just engaged with Script Labs, but I kind of... just financed it by working freelance, and then when the script is ready, I approached financiers, because in India it works very differently. We don't get soft funding for films at all, so I really don't have a choice. And then I had a French co-producer, and luckily we didn't find the development funding. We tried a lot. I didn't give up, and I did it myself. Having done that in the first amount of desperation, I would continue doing that in my next film, because that's where you earn your freedom. And after that, it's like, take it or don't take it kind of a thing. I mean, I figured that out for myself, that would give me the freedom. Sometimes you do find producers who love and agree with everything that you make, but you can never be sure about it. Because we were just hiring talent as we wanted, and most of them were in the decision-making positions. And that's also because, as I said earlier, animation is a very young field in India. There's still not that much power and money in it for the men to like come and take over. And as long as that does not happen, it's a good scenario. And I think after the Me Too movement and all, it's not going to happen. So we're kind of lucky that this balance will always remain. Unlike the studios in the West, where women have been relegated to the paint team. Or in animation, essentially the painters are and the manual labor is done by women. Like if you say, take Disney or Pixar or any other animation studios, the directors, which Disney, Pixar, DreamWorks animation film has been directed by a woman? I think none. I must do my Googling, but I think none.
One or two, but
out of hundreds.
Yeah, hardly.
So in that sense, yeah, we just achieved it without really making an effort. Probably because I was a woman and I've worked with women all my life and my producers were women, and coincidentally everybody who agreed to take a risk and make this film happen and agreed to take on the hard work and to continue to make it happen turned out to be women. So yeah, it was like about 38%, which I think is great.
Okay, women.